BlueCast X-One is at the Prusa store. X-One was launched last year and it has been independently reviewed and tested extensively by many professionals around the world. It has consistently come out on top as one of the best on the market today for jewelry and dental applications. X-One features easy printing, post-processing, and requires little to no extra equipment to achieve perfect results. We let our partner, the Clear Mind Jewellery from Canada, to test this resin. From printing to casting, it turns out to be a really great product, which is why we added it to our portfolio of resins. Like most resins, shake the bottle to ensure all the chemical components are mixed well before printing. BlueCast has applied a temperature-sensitive sticker to each bottle of X-One. Simply set the required preheating temperature on the Prusa CW1S to 30 degrees Celsius and set the timer to 20 minutes, or monitor the bottle until it reaches 30 degrees Celsius. If you don't have CW1S, you can also heat the resin in a bowl of hot water, in an ultrasonic machine, or even in a microwave. Preheating the resin is important because the chemical wax-like components within the resin need to be thoroughly melted to incorporate properly. While you're waiting for the resin to warm up, prepare your models for printing in Prusa Slicer. That should be fairly easy using the automatic supports and the verified BlueCast X-One resin profile. Once the resin is heated and the prints are prepared, pour the resin into the SL1S speed vat and start the print. Remove the prints from the build plate and wash it as usual in ethyl or isopropyl alcohol. Then, unlike virtually every other resin on the market, leave the print in the alcohol for 5 to 10 minutes, depending on how large it is. This is a critical step in the post-processing. Leaving the prints to soak in alcohol is BlueCast's solution to the final post-curing process. There is no further UV curing required after the alcohol soak. After soaking the prints, you will notice that they have changed color, going from dark greenish-black after the initial printing to a bone-gray color. According to BlueCast, color uniformity is not too important for this use case. Leaving prints to soak in alcohol for too long may cause prints breakage or poor casting results. Having a few minor darker spots, in our experience, does not affect overall casting quality. X-One prints are fairly soft and flexible. Support removal may be done with snips or a sharp blade. Prints can now be prepared for casting. Attach a sprue to the model using casting wax, assuming sprues were not printed in place. This acts as a runner for the molten metal to flow through. Attach the model to a central wax column, creating what's known as a tree. In this case, we are casting multiple pieces all at once. We are using vacuum casting in this case, but X-One is appropriate for all types of lost wax casting methods. Next, mix the plaster investment. Most types of gypsum bonded investment are suitable for casting BlueCast X-One. However, we recommend to play safe and use investment designed for casting 3D printed resin, such as R&R Plasticast or Certus Optima Prestige. For the best possible results, follow the manufacturer's instruction precisely, whichever investment you choose. Allow the investment to rest and harden for 4 to 6 hours. Now into the kiln for burnout. This melts the resin away and cures the investment, leaving a hollow cavity in the plaster that we will fill with metal. Burnout schedules will vary depending on your investment and flask size. Once again, follow the manufacturer's instructions exactly. Here is the R&R Plasticast schedule we used. Starting with your flask in the kiln at room temperature or at 150 degrees Celsius. Water removal at 150 degrees Celsius for 1 to 3 hours. Thermal transition stage from 150 to 370 degrees Celsius over 1 to 2 hours. Then hold 370 degrees Celsius for 1 to 2 hours. Pattern removal stage, raising from 370 to 730 degrees Celsius over 2 to 3 hours. Hold 730 degrees Celsius for 2 to 3 hours. Reduce the casting temperature over 1 to 2 hours. Pour in the metal. Allow the flask to cool for 5 to 15 minutes or until the metal on top is no longer glowing red. Quench the flask into water. Clean off the excess investment with a stiff brush, ultrasonic machine or a pressure washer. Finally, it's time for some cutting, sanding and polishing. And you're done! Happy printing!